So what to do if you're having issues with jagged or pixelated text? To answer your question in about 5 seconds, this text is jagged. Double click on the T and change the anti-aliasing mode from none to sharp. And now have a look. It is wonderful, isn't it? 5 seconds over, let me explain this. So when you have the anti-aliasing mode AA set to none, Photoshop does not apply any anti-aliasing. So that's why you see these jagged edges. Now we will understand this even more a little later, but have a look at this. Either the pixel is completely filled or it is not. So it's either totally black or it's not. Therefore, you are seeing these jagged edges. But when you select the text by double clicking on the T and then change the anti-aliasing mode to sharp, have a look. A little bit of anti-aliasing has been applied around the edges, and we will just understand what exactly happens here. And it gives you an illusion that this has become smoother. Let's go a little deeper and understand this with a simple example. So let's say you had a circle, and imagine these boxes as pixels. And the shape, the edge of the shape, is going through a pixel. How do you think your pixel-based raster image would represent it? So what happens is usually, if there is no anti-aliasing, if a pixel is more than 50% filled, it will totally fill it because a pixel cannot be half filled. So let's take the brush and let's take this color. It will be totally filled, just like this. And sorry about my drawing. And if a pixel is less than 50% filled, it will not be filled. It will be erased. And that is why you were seeing jagged edges. So this is how the text was processed if you choose none. So if you select the text and if you choose none, this is what exactly happened. If it is 50% or more, it will be filled. If it is less than 50%, it won't be filled. And that is why it has jagged edges. However, when you select one of the anti-aliasing modes like sharp, crisp, strong, or whatever you want, let's select sharp. What happens is if a pixel is 20% filled, in other words, let's suppose this is a pixel and only 20% of the pixel space is being taken by the shape. So the pixel will fill with the color of the shape, but with 20% opacity. Similarly, if the shape is taking, let's say, 60% of the space of the pixel, it will fill it with 60% opacity, giving you an illusion of smoothness. And that is what anti-aliasing is in super simple mathematics. I'm sure there's a lot more math that goes into it, but this is a super simple way to understand it. So simply put, when you're working with texts, just select any one of these anti-aliasing modes. Now there's a tiny difference when it comes to other modes like crisp, and have a look at the difference. And by the way, when you have the text selected and you still want to change the font and the other stuff, you can always hide this selection momentarily by pressing Ctrl or Command H. It hides. It's still selected, but it hides. Have a look at the differences. So this is sharp. This is crisp. Let's zoom in to see the differences even better. This is strong. This is smooth. So you can play with them, see what you like, but I always go for sharp. Here's a quick description of all the modes from Adobe's website. Just keep in mind, none means it applies no anti-aliasing. And the rest are anti-aliasing modes. I hope this video helped you, and if it did, make sure to give us a like, and also don't forget to subscribe, and not just subscribe. Ring the bell so that you, my friend, don't miss any other future tip, trick, or tutorial. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you guys in my next one. Till then, stay tuned and make sure that you keep creating.